In Zenject, contexts are the glue between the containers and your installers. Each container is attached to a context, and each context has a list of your installers. This is how each container knows which dependencies it needs to create. In a perfect world, your applications would only ever need a single context. But as a developer, you already know nothing is ever that simple. Zenject provides four types of contexts: scene context, game context, decorator context, and project context. The scene context is the entry point of each scene. It's the first script that gets executed once the project context is initialized. And it's where all of the scene's dependencies get created and initialized. The game object context is a subcontainer context. It serves as a grouping mechanism for your dependencies on a per game object basis. Each scene can have multiple instances of the same game object context. They're typically used to implement the facade pattern, which is a design pattern that I'll cover in a future video. The decorator context is a nested context that's attached to its own scene. Its purpose is to dynamically add functionality to a scene through Unity's multi-scene editing feature. It does this by nesting itself to the scene context of the scene that it's added to. Unlike the game object context, the decorator context and the scene context share the same container. And finally, the project context is a global context that lives as a prefab in the resources folder. It's used to create project-wide global dependencies. The project context only gets initialized once, at the very start of the application, and its dependencies are reused in every scene. All four of these context types can be used simultaneously to achieve a highly granular object graph for your project. But to get the most out of these contexts, it's important to understand the order in which they're initialized. It all begins during Unity's awake phase. The project context is the first context type to be initialized. This happens only once during the entire lifecycle of the application. First, each model behavior that's attached to the project context prefab is passed to the project context container. Then, the install bindings method is called on each installer that's attached to the project context component. Finally, all non-lazy objects that are found within these installers are constructed. Once the project context is complete, the scene context is initialized following the same process. It's important to note that if a decorator context exists, it will also be initialized during this step. Last but not least, each game object context in the scene is initialized. Again, the same set of steps are followed. Although there are a few advanced features that aren't covered in this video, contexts are pretty straightforward. They allow you to group up or separate the dependencies in your project. In the next video, we're going to be taking a look at the non-monobehavior classes that are available in Zenject. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and a comment letting me know what you thought. And for more Unity tutorials just like this one, please subscribe with notifications on. And if you'd like to support the creation of content like this, please consider becoming a patron on the Infallible Code Patreon page.